Hi guys, Chris from Adapt Tuition here, and in this video, I'm going to show you the solution for question 4 from the Jan 2017 POA paper 2. If you want to see the other solutions for this paper, I'm going to put a card up there and a link in the description below, so be sure to check that out. And with that said, let's get into the solution. Okay, so as we usually do, we take a read. Let's start off. So Warwick Car Wrecking Company has been in operation for 3 years using 2 wrecking trucks. On 31st August 2016, the end of the third accounting period, the new accountant noticed that the company had recorded depreciation on its wrecking trucks in the following ways. So in the first year, they use the straight line method. But in the second year, they use the reducing balance method on the net book value at the end of year one. I don't think that's a good thing to do. So based on the above information, what do they want? Name 2 financial statements which were affected by the error described above. Well, I mean, the only 2 financial statements you all know at this level are the income statement and the balance sheet. Or, I mean, as they're calling it now, the statement of financial position. That's because we have 2 aspects. We have the expense aspect, which is recorded in the income statement, and we have the contra asset, the balance, which is recorded in the balance sheet, statement of financial position. So those 2 financial statements would have been affected. Next. Name the accounting principle that was not being followed by the company. That's easy, that's the consistency principle, right? The consistency concept was not being followed. Okay, let's scroll along and take a look at the next part of the question. So it says, to correct the error, the new accountant presents the following information. So we have in this table, asset, which is vehicles. The cost is 160,000. Years of useful life, 8. Depreciation method, reducing balance, rate 30%. Okay, so, using all the information provided, calculate the balance which had been brought down in error in the provision for depreciation account as at 1st September 2015. And they give you a nice little format to use here, and it's for 5 marks. Okay, so let's take a look and see how I approached it. Okay, so let's put, so the name of the method in year one was a straight line method. Under the straight line method, we depreciate the asset using the same value every year. And the formula is cost minus residual value, all divided by the estimated useful life. The cost of the asset was $160,000. We are given no information as to the residual value, so we could assume 0, and we have to divide by 8 years. So that's exactly what we are going to do, right? So we're going to take 160 minus 0, divide by 8, and that's going to give us $20,000 for the depreciation in the first year. Now, in the second year, they told us that the reducing balance method was used on the net book value at the end of year one. So in year two, it's the reducing balance method. And how do we calculate depreciation using the reducing balance method? Well, we multiply the percentage by the net book value. Now, how do we find net book value? We take the cost of the asset, 160, we subtract the depreciation, and then we multiply. Okay, so let's take a look at that. So, all right, so the 30%, which is the rate from above, multiplied by the 160 minus 20, which is 140, and that's going to give us 42,000. And then all we have to do to find the depreciation figure is add 20 and 42, which gives us the 62,000. So that is the incorrect depreciation that is brought down in the depreciation account. Okay, let's take a look at the next part of the question. Okay, so it says that Warwick's owner has agreed that the reducing balance method should be used for the calculation of depreciation on the wrecking trucks. So using the information on page 17 and the form below, calculate the amount that should appear in the provision for depreciation account as at 31st August 2016. So depreciation expense on wrecking trucks using reducing balance method, and they're giving us a little table here with these 3 headings, which as you can see, I have reproduced below. Okay, so what we want to do is we are basically going to recalculate the depreciation starting from year one using the reducing balance method with a rate of 30% per annum. So let's go. So in year one, right, which is that column there, the value at the start is 160,000. The depreciation is 30%. So if we multiply that by 30%, we're going to get 48,000. Now the net book value at end is the cost 160 minus the 48, which is going to give us 112. And the value at the end of year one becomes the value at the start of year two. So the value at the start of year two is 112,000. We multiply that by the 30% per annum. That's going to give us 33,600. And to find the value, the net book value at the end of year two, we subtract the 33,600 from the 112 at start. And that's going to give us 784. And the net book value at the end of year two becomes the net book value at the start of year three. We again multiply by 30%, which is going to give us 23,520, and we subtract that figure, right, from the 784 at start to find the net book value at the end of the year. And at the very end, what we wanted was the depreciation expense that should have been charged, right? The amount that should appear in the provision for depreciation account. And that would be the sum of the three depreciation figures. So these three figures here, 48 plus the 33.6 plus the 23,520. And that's summarized down here in this section. And therefore, the depreciation figure that should have been recorded, well, in total, is 105,120. Okay, we have one more part of this question to go. Okay, so this is the last part of the question. It's pretty interesting. So it says, at the end of the second year, the owner of Warwick Car Wrecking Company had recorded a balance of $86,900 in his personal account in the general ledger. So you might be asking yourself, what personal account? How does the owner have an account? Well, that's a capital account. Think about it. Why do people start businesses? To make a profit. Therefore, at the end of the reporting period, to whom does the profit go? It goes to the owner. Well, profit or loss. It's transferred to the owner's capital account. If it's a profit, you credit the capital account to show the increase in the owner's investment. If it's a loss, you debit the capital account to show the decrease in the owner's investment. So how would that have been affected in this question? Well, let's take a look. If we look back up at our first piece of the question, our initial depreciation was 20,000 in year one and 42 in year two for a total of 62. But in our corrected working, what we are noticing is that the depreciation in year one was supposed to be 48 and the depreciation in year two was supposed to be 33,600. That's a total of 81,006. So what happened was we understated depreciation. So if your expenses are too low, your profit is too high. So it means that too much was transferred to the owner's capital account. So we now have to go and bring it back down to reflect the correct depreciation charges. So let me scroll down and I'll show you guys that a little working. So again, the depreciation, the correct depreciation was 81,600. The incorrect depreciation that we actually did charge was 62,000. So the difference is 19,6. And that 19,6 has to be debited to capital because once again, the profit was overstated. So too much was sent to capital. So we have to reduce capital. And to reduce capital, you need to debit the capital account. And then the credit would go to the depreciation account, the provision for depreciation, because that account would have been understated. We didn't put enough into it. Therefore, we now have to go and put more to increase it. And the provision for depreciation is a contra asset. And therefore, to increase it, we have to credit. Now, they did say to put a proper narration. So I have it to record the adjustment needed to correct the error with the depreciation figure and the capital account for the years ended August 31st, 2014 and 2015. Okay, ladies and gents, that's about it for this question. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to see more playlists or more videos, I'm going to put some cards up here. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell. And don't forget to check out my website for free POA handouts. Anyway, guys, thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.